It appears that corporate Democrats are so salty about the socialist candidate winning the Democratic primary in Buffalo's mayoral race that some of them in the council are considering doing away with the mayoral role altogether. Now, the way that this is being reported on makes it appear as though the target is actually not India Walton, the socialist candidate who just won the Democratic primary for the mayoral race. And by the way, she's likely to move forward to become mayor because it is a heavily blue area. They're trying to make it seem like they're focused on the incumbent mayor who's also a corporate Democrat. But let me give you the details and you guys can judge for yourselves. Now, the Buffalo Common Council will explore, according to the Buffalo News, a city manager form of governance to replace the office of mayor. Under such plan, a city manager would be selected by the 9-member council in conjunction with the community to, quote, carry out the will of the council members, University Council member Rashid Wyatt said. Now, Wyatt claims, look, this is all about Byron Brown. That's the incumbent mayor. It's not about India Walton, okay? And to be sure, Wyatt does have problems with Brown. He does. But Brown ain't gonna be in power much longer. In fact, the council adopted a resolution on Tuesday of this week. South Council member Christopher Scanlon voted in the negative, saying that a majority of 5 council members selecting a city manager instead of tens of thousands of voters appointing a mayor could lead to some nefarious behavior. And you know, again, when it comes to those advocating for it, they're like, no, look, we've got issues with Brown. He's implemented cameras, speeding cameras, for instance, in poor areas of Buffalo, New York, and that's the area that I represent, so we want to hold him accountable. But again, they're calling for a report on this. They want to look into it. The report will be completed 2 weeks before the mayoral race takes place, right? So yeah. Why are we having a conversation about this as if it's about the incumbent mayor, when in reality, this is about the incoming socialist mayor?
Yeah. So every once in a while I say, why don't Democrats fight back with Republican tactics? So Republicans will you know, take away voting areas, voting booths from predominantly Democratic areas, right? And so then you'll have really long lines. You've all seen it on TV, right? You're not supposed to have really long lines when you're voting. They do that so that less Democrats vote. It becomes more inconvenient. You never see long lines in Republican areas, almost never, right? So I said, why don't they just use the same tactics? Okay, you want to do long lines? We'll do long lines. Okay, in purple states we control, that's it. Hey, oh, hey, conveniently, oh, we ran out of money. We had to take away all the voting booths from the Republican areas. Just a coincidence, just like you guys do, right? Unfortunately, Democrats have listened to my advice, but instead of using Republican tactics against Republicans, they're using it against progressives. So they remember the Republican tactic of, hey, a governor, Democratic governor won in North Carolina and won in Wisconsin, but it was still Republican legislatures. So they're like, now let's just take away the power of the governor. So now corporate Democrats have come in, oh, a Democratic socialist won? Well, let's just take away the power of the mayor. Let's remember our buddies, our corporate buddies, the Republicans, they do this to us every once in a while. Now we're never gonna do it back to them because our funders say that we have to kiss their ass, right? But if a progressive one, let's just end the idea of a mayor in Buffalo. Because I mean, then you might hold the cops responsible for cracking the skull of 70-year-olds protesters, right? God forbid, you don't want that, right? And I also have to point out their absurdities. They say, oh, we've had a mayor here for so long, and now there's less people who live in Buffalo. So let's get rid of the mayor. You've also had a city council for all that time. Should we get rid of the city council that you're on?
No, we should empower that city council to decide who gets to be the leader of Buffalo, right? Yeah. They get to decide on their own without, you know, the votes of the tens of thousands of people living in Buffalo, who gets to serve that role as city manager.
The problem is we used to have journalists that had outrage. They would say, wait, they would point out this obvious hypocrisy we just pointed out.
Right.
There was a mayor all this time, there was a city council all this time. The city council is saying get rid of the mayor. Why? How about you guys? Why shouldn't we get rid? And you say, hey, some things have gone wrong in Buffalo, so let's get rid of the mayor? Some things have gone wrong, so let's get rid of democracy?
It's insane.
Are there reporters in Buffalo? They should be tearing these guys apart. But you know, I don't know if it's because it's their corporate Democrats, so you can, if you're in the reporter, like that's Reporter 101 never criticized a corrupt Democrat.
No, but what's also interesting is someone like Donald Trump received and certainly deserved a lot of criticism in the media for not accepting the results of the 2020 election. But then you take a look at what's going down in Buffalo with the incumbent mayor, Byron Brown, who lost in the primary. He lost. He lost to India Walton, the socialist candidate. And he refuses to concede. In fact, he is encouraging the people of Buffalo to write his name in instead. That is a Trump tactic, the unwillingness to accept defeat. And you're right. I mean, Democrats, if they really want to, do implement strategies to maintain power. It's just that they don't implement those strategies when they're trying to maintain power against Republicans. But they certainly do deploy those tactics when they're trying to beat progressives or Democratic socialist candidates like India Walton. So we'll see how this all plays out. But don't let the media lie to you and make you think that this effort to do away with the mayor's position is really about Byron Brown. No, it's about India Walton. There's no question about it.
Yeah, and if Bernie Sanders had run as a third party candidate, they would have shredded. Everybody knows that. No one would deny that. The media would have shredded him. He's canning the election to Donald Trump. And there would have been some truth to that, by the way. But when corporate Democrats do it, well, you lost the election to the progressive in this case. Why don't you get out? You guys said unity. Nope, no, that's totally fine. No, we don't want the progressive winning. We'd rather have the Republican win. Who cares? I'm not going to get out of that race. No, I'm going to try to ruin it for the progressive, because I'm much closer to a Republican than I am to a progressive. Exactly. By the way, Kara Eastman had her election won. She was a Justice Democrat in Nebraska too. She's leading the polls. Her former corporate Democratic primary opponent did a giant ad for the Republican. Literally did an ad for the Republican saying, now make sure you don't vote for the Democrat, vote for the Republican, okay? Corporate Democrats didn't mind at all, never said a word about it, never shunned him, never criticized him, right? Oh, bravo, way to destroy a progressive. There's one less Democrat, and who cares? Unity, my ass. They never cared about unity. And look at what they're doing to Nina Turner right now. Oh, we need to have unity. A progressive is winning? Send in millions of dollars in lobbyist money. Send in Democratic Majority for Israel, ExxonMobil, Comcast, calling all corrupt Democrats. Warning, there's a progressive who might win in Ohio's 11th district. NinaTurner.com/hello. These guys are liars and they lie all the time and they're aided and abetted by the press. Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun, but you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.